Hi guys, this is Lucy Yakuza, and today I'm gonna break down some of my music video with Vivo.
La vie est une chienne qu'il faut tenir en laisse. Vivre me hante, tout ce qui m'entoure m'a rendu méchante.
So, in my first music video, Dilemme, directed by Wendy Morgan, I wanted people to know who I am and the duality that lives in me. So, basically, there's a lot of people living in my head, but there's two main characters, and I want people to, you know, meet the two main characters. You know, that's the reason why this song is called Dilemme. It's because I'm always having a huge dilemma in picking the right personality for the day. Originally, we were not going to have choreography. That was not something I envisioned for any of my visuals. But then Wendy Morgan, the director, is such a fan of dance, and I dance all the damn time. Like, I dance all the time. So she was like, why don't we include that in your visuals? But I was not insecure about the dancing, but I was like, I'm not a professional dancer. Like, what is it gonna look like? But then we find every single time the right partner, the right choreographer, the right dancers. In Tout est Gore, I wanted people to see blood as something that is not a scary thing. As a woman, I see blood every month. I'm forced by nature to see it every single month. And I remember some of my family, they were like, oh my God, it's witchcraft. And I was like, no, it's not. We bleed every month. It's not a scary thing. It actually regulates our body. Like, blood is a positive thing in my life. As a woman, you know, like, because of my period. So I wanted that to be very visible. That's why my favorite scene of the video is when I'm sitting on the stairs and there's like massive blood coming down the stairs. And it's not shaking me.
Parce qu'on a trop de fierté. Toujours devoir se battre. Oh non. Toujours devoir se défendre. Oh non, non. Se battre jusqu'à la muerte. Parce qu'on a trop de fierté.
So when I wrote Solo, I was so sad. That's why I said, must I scream to be heard in the lyrics, is because sometimes I feel like I have to scream and speak louder to be heard, which is what I feel like women feel so often, or black women feel so often, or, you know, any type of population that is seen as a minority. So I met Sfera and Chablo differently, because basically I went to perform as a guest at X Factor Italy, my first ever single, so I was very confused already. I was like, what am I doing here? Because it was like a stadium, so I was like, what? So many people. I was scared, and I had like choreography and all that, like massive gowns. And after the show, I didn't know, but Sfera was one of the judge, you know, or something like that. And then he said, your song is fire, or something like this. He texted me after, and I was like, oh my God, thank you. And then at the same time, Chablo is his manager, but he's also a producer, and I didn't know that. So Chablo was like, yo, I have these beats for you and everything. So he kept sending me beats. And one day, I loved the beat. I did a song on it. And a couple days after, Sfera texts me randomly, hey, let's make a hit. And I'm like, what? Okay. J'aurais dû t'aider à soigner tes mots. On finira de haut commissariat. Je changerai pas quitter même si j'ai le choix. Juste une seule nuit bercée dans tes bras. Working with Wendy is crazy. You will know what the video is maybe the day before you're on set. Like, it's crazy. And she was super careful about the lighting, the everything, the cast, everything, because like, I was so scared that as a black woman, I would have the worst lighting in the world, or, you know, all the things that I see so often, the worst makeup, the worst everything, you know? And she was so specific, just like me. She put the exact same energy And she was, and she made me comfortable expressing my culture, my way, my upbringing, like all of that. She was so supportive in who I was as a human and as an artist. So when I started this new album, the visuals for this new album, I wanted her to be part of the history from the start again. So the whole video is referenced to many of his movies that he directed or wrote, like he did the scenario of so many of his movies. And what I love about every single one of his movies is the way he has such a beautiful way to write about feelings, you know? And my song personally is about all the monsters you live with peacefully. That's why the song starts with Not All Monsters Are Bad. The video is directed by Tobox Bronski. He's amazing. He directed a few of my live performances. And because that video is a one shot, I wanted him to direct it. And he did such a wonderful job. That was like a challenge to make all of this in one shot. But I'm so happy we made it. And he was also so into it. I think like giving anime briefs to directors is something exciting for them because they're like, what the fuck is this? And you know, and there's so many ways to interpret it. There's so many ways to make it happen, you know? Thank you so much everyone for watching my Footnote Live. It was a pleasure to be here. Bisous!